Hi guys, so welcome back to the third episode. So I am hoping that you watched the previous two episodes, or at least the episode two where I was explaining the financial statements. Now, just to continue the same thing about financial statements, now you know that financial statements consist of a balance sheet, profit and loss account, cash flow statement, notes to accounts, and statement of changes in equity, these five things. Now, I'll go more detail into the balance sheet. Okay, so this is a very important video. So please don't skip ahead or watch it. I would suggest having a pen or paper and try to follow the lecture. So let's get started. Okay, so I've done over here is, let me share my screen. So what I've tried to do over here, so let me see, I hope I am visible. So hopefully I'm visible. So let's get started. So what I've done over here is I've divided the balance sheet into multiple stages. Now, if you kind of look at the balance sheet at one go, and if you see the entire balance sheet format, right? So let me just share my screen again and show you the format of a balance sheet, or maybe we'll do it later. Let's move in step by step first. Okay. So I have kind of broken the balance sheet down into multiple stages so that it's easier for you to grasp it slowly instead of just going into this entire large format. Okay. So the first thing about the balance sheet is there are three things. One is equity, liability, and asset. So the entire purpose of the balance sheet is to show me where my sources of funds are and where I'm applying them. So sources of fund means where I'm getting the money, and application of fund means where I'm using that money. Got it? Now, source of fund can be two types. One is equity and one is liability. And then all of that are classified as assets on the application side. Okay. I hope this part is clear. I'll just move on ahead a little bit. Now, just take this side. I'm zooming in. Okay. And I'm figuring out where I'm getting the money from. Equity is basically the money that I'm getting from my owners. And liability is that money that I'm getting from my borrowers. So any kind of loan, any kind of advances that I've received from my suppliers. So those are liabilities. And equity is basically any kind of money that I've got from my owners. Okay. So this is how I've got money. And then I've used that money to create assets. Okay. So that's the basic stage two right now. Let's move a little deeper into second stage. Now, just for a minute, forget about the equity part. Okay. Let's take the equity and forget it right now. Liabilities and assets can be classified into two headings. One is your non-current liability, and one is your current liability. And similarly, assets can be classified as non-current asset and current asset. Now, what are these current and non-current terms, you might be thinking? So earlier, in the earlier format, they used to be called as short-term liabilities and long-term liabilities. But now the name has changed to current liabilities. So over here, as I mentioned, that current means any short-term. So it's like any current payments that I have to make is called or short-term payments or short-term liabilities or assets that I have are called current liabilities. So for us, in a simple view, you can assume that any kind of payments that have to be made within 12 months or any kind of money that I'll be getting within 12 months, those are my current assets or current liabilities. And any kind of money that I'm getting either 12 months or beyond 12 months are my non-current assets or non-current liabilities. I hope this part is clear. Now, 12 months is not a fixed thing that is followed everywhere. So the accounting standard says that basically any item is called current if it's within the normal operating cycle of that business. So for example, my business might be such that my business operations are only for 9 months, and then 3 months, or maybe 6 month cycle is there in my business. So in that case, my business, if my business is of 6 months, so any payments that I'm due to receive or make payments within 6 months, those are all short term. And any payments that I have due to receive beyond 6 months, that would be long term. But for simplicity, right now, assume that any payments or receipts which are within 12 months are current, right? So that is stage three. I hope all of you are with me. So just to reiterate, we have equity, liability, assets. Okay, I hope you are with me. Now let's move on to the next part. Now this two part, now liability and assets, we already figured that out. Move this aside. Okay, now let's focus on the equity part. So equity part has mainly two things. One is your shareholders fund, and then share application money pending allotment. So as I had said, that equity is basically the money that belongs to your shareholders or owners. Okay, so for a sole proprietorship, who is the owner? For a sole proprietorship, the owner is the person who has invested the money in the initial days. So the proprietor is the owner. For a partnership firm, who is the owner? The partners. Okay. So instead of in a partnership account, you'll see within the you'll see the partner share capital, current account, capital account and stuff. But in a company, who is the owner? The owner is the shareholder. Okay. So in equity, if I say, there are two things. One is the shareholders fund, and then a share application money pending allotment. So shareholders fund is the fund that is created by, not only by the money that the shareholder has invested in the initial, the face value of the share, plus any accumulated profits over the years. And share application money is basically the money that has been received and shares have not yet been allotted for them. Okay, so I hope they are clear. Equity consists of shareholders fund, share application money, liabilities, non-current liabilities, current liabilities, asset, non-current asset, current asset. I hope this is clear. Very good. Now I'm just going deeper into the equity part. Within shareholders fund, there is share capital. So share cap. So right now, forget about money against share warrants and share application money payment allotment. These are very rare things that happen. Mostly in the balance sheet, you'll not find these things because these are very rare events where the company has issued share and then the balance sheet date has come and then you have not been able to allot those shares. So don't really worry about money against share warrants and share application money pending allotment. Even for questions and stuff in exams, we have never delved too much deeply into these things. Two main important things are share capital and reserves and surplus. Okay. But for obviously for the format, you have to maintain the format. So equity has shareholders fund. Within shareholder fund, there is share capital, reserves and surplus, money or share warrants. Okay. Now, what is share capital? Share capital is basically the entire face value of that share. So any share that is issued is generally, let's say the share is issued for 10 rupees per share. So in share capital, you calculate only the face value of that share. Doesn't really matter what the market price of the share is. Market price, it might be trading at 10,000 rupees per share. But in the share capital, you take it only as the face value of the share, which is written on the share certificate. Reserves and surplus is basically the reserve that had been accumulated over the year. Okay. So for example, here I mentioned reserves and surplus includes the capital reserve, securities premium, revaluation reserve, surplus from the profit and loss account, and earmarked funds. So capital reserve, so one thing you can see is the surplus from profit and loss account. So every year what happens is what happens every year is the profit is accumulated, the company is earning profit, and if it does not distribute that profit, that money goes into the reserves and surplus for later distribution. So I don't really want to get into these points and explain each and every detail because that will right now it'll be a lot for you. Okay, so maybe I'll create a separate video for reserves and surplus. So I hope equity part is clear. Let's move on to the next part. Now we are talking about debt. We are talking about liabilities. Yeah. So let's now start and talk about the liabilities part. So liabilities, as I said, liabilities are the monies that you borrow from your borrow to. So there, when you start a business, you either invest on your own. If you invest on your own, that money is called equity. And if you borrow funds from, let's say you take a loan, that is called a liability because you're borrowing that money and you have the liability to pay it back. Now, liabilities can be of two types, as we know, non-current liability and current liability. Now, don't really get confused by these long, long words and like what they are. Generally, it's classified as borrowings, deferred tax liabilities, payables, other liabilities, provisions. Okay, so you can memorize this however you want. But my job over here is to kind of explain what these things are. So borrowings, long-term borrowings are basically loans that you take from banks and stuff. So any long-term borrowing is any loan that you have to pay beyond 12 months. That is a long-term borrowing. Any loan that you have to pay back within 12 months, that is a short-term borrowing. Okay, so don't look at it in a list. You see this thing, long-term borrowing and short-term borrowing are same. Deferred tax liability. Deferred tax liability, I'll deal with it in a separate video because it's an entire different thing and it has a different standard altogether, which deals with deferred tax liability. So I'm not touching this part right now. We'll deal with it later. Okay. Long-term liabilities, other long-term liabilities. So before I do that, trade payables. So trade payables is basically your creditors. So creditors, what happens is creditors are generally within 12 months. So that's why if there are any creditors within 12 months, you classify them as trade payables. Like trade payables would be like, suppose you purchase some supplies from your supplier. Okay. Any material you purchase from a supplier and he has said that, okay, you take the material, give it back to me in 2 months. So that is called a trade payable and it's captured over here under current liabilities. If this trade payable was more than 12 months, then that case it would be captured over here under other long-term liabilities. Now, other than trade payables, because trade payable is generally a very significant portion of your liabilities. So that's why it's shown separately in a separate line item. But other than trade payables, there might be other things like other non-current liabilities. So other non-current liabilities, you can club them together and put them under the same head, other non-current liabilities. And if these liabilities are more than 12 months, in that case, it will be other long-term liabilities. And then there are provisions. So long-term provisions and short-term provisions. So provision is basically provision for bad debt, provision for depreciation. So provision is basically something that the company provides for. So it's a future possible, is an expense that is possible in the future that company is providing for right now. Okay. So don't get confused with so much, I would say words. It's very, very simple. So it's long-term borrowing, short-term borrowing, deferred. This is different. Deferred tax liability is different and trade payable is different. Then again, this third point, other long-term liabilities, other current liabilities, long-term provision and short-term provision. Perfect. Now let's move on to the asset side. I hope you are with me and you have not skipped the video. And I just hope that you're loving the video so far. And if you have any questions, you can definitely reach out to me. Okay. Now, assets. So assets, basically, there are two kinds of assets. We saw non-current and current. Again, it's the same thing. 12 months, it's less than 12 months, it's current. It's 12 or more than non-current. Okay. Now, these generally are not in the same way. Like in the liabilities, we saw that it's mostly the same. Borrowing, other long-term liabilities, like other liabilities, other things. So it's mostly similar, but in assets, it's a little bit different. So what happens is in assets, there are two kinds of things. One is your property, plant and equipment, which is also known as PPE. Okay, so PPE is basically all your machinery, land, building, all these assets that generally, if you ask anyone what assets are, they'll say these things: property, plant, equipment, and land, building, machinery, all these things. Non-current investments are basically investments that have been made for a long term. So, for example, in the asset side, I'm dealing with what? Asset side, I'm dealing with my application for the fund. So once I start a business, I can either apply my funds to purchase land, purchase machinery, purchase assets, or I can be like, okay, right now I don't want to invest that money. I don't want to purchase anything, but I want to maybe I'll need that money 5 years or 10 years later. So in that case, what we do is we make a long-term investment. That investment could be in shares, that investment could be in debentures and stuff. So like any kind of long-term investment that has been done, those are classified under anything more than 12 months that are classified as non-current investment. So non-current investment, similarly current investments. Okay. So there's nothing called a PPE in current investment because any kind of machinery is generally long term. Okay, you don't have a 12 month machine. So that's why you see this head here and you don't see this head over here. Got it? Now, again, deferred tax asset, we saw the same thing in liability. So here in liabilities, you saw deferred tax liability. And here again, you say deferred tax asset. So both things will not be there at the same time. It will either be deferred tax asset or deferred tax liability as a whole. And that's how it will be presented in the balance sheet. So don't worry about deferred tax asset right now. All right. After that, there are a few items: inventories, trade receivable, and cash and cash equivalent, which are very specific to current assets. So inventories is basically my stock in trade. So any kind of material, finished good, work in progress, those are my inventories. And generally these inventories are used within that 12 month period. So inventories are current assets. Trade receivable, just like trade payable. So if you see the other earlier balance sheet, you can see trade payables was there. So trade payable, what was trade payable? Trade payable was any kind of money that I was owing to my supplier. In the same way, trade receivables means any money that I am yet to receive from my customer. So maybe I have paid my customer, I have given my goods to the customer and I have told him that you pay me 1 month later. So in that case, it's a trade receivable. Cash and cash equivalent. So cash and cash equivalent are basically cash, you know. Cash includes cash, bank, any short-term investment which are highly liquid. Okay. So perhaps we'll get into this when we do cash flow statement, but you know, see, cash can't be a long-term asset. Cash is always current asset because I can sell, like I can transact using cash at any time. So that's why cash is a current asset. And then again, see, last 2 points are same: short-term loans and advances, long-term loans and advances, other current asset, other non-current asset. So last two lines are the same. These three things are very specific to current assets. That's why these things are not there in non-current. Again, current investment, non-current investment, and property, plant, equipment is specific to non-current asset. So I hope you guys are following so far. Okay, everyone is following. Let's do a recap. Okay, or should we move ahead? Let's move ahead once. So now if I go into my property, plant, equipment a little more, I'll dig deeper and I'll classify these a little more. And so any kind of asset can be classified into two kinds. So any kind of, see, earlier this used to be called fixed assets. Property, plant, equipment is a new name, Earlier, this used to be called fixed assets. Now, fixed assets can be two things. One is tangible asset and intangible asset. Tangible assets are any assets that I can touch. So it could be a building, it could be a machinery, it could be a car, it could be a bike, it could be anything that I can touch. That is a tangible asset. Intangible asset are all those assets that I have, which I cannot physically touch, but I know I have them. So for example, I buy a patent from a company. That patent is an intangible asset because I can't touch that patent. Goodwill is an intangible asset. Royalties or any kind of licenses that I have, those are all intangible assets. So think of it, these four things are basically two things. One is tangible asset, one is intangible asset. Now, when the tangible asset, so for example, I have made a down payment on a building that is being created. So for example, I am making a factory. Factory is not ready yet. Factory is still being made. So during the period the factory is being made, I'll classify that factory as a capital work in progress because that factory is not tangible yet, but still I've made payments and I want to show my shareholders that I'm working on that asset. So anything that is in the process of work in progress, any tangible assets which is in work in progress, that I'll show in capital work in progress, and any intangible assets which are still under development. So maybe I'm doing R&D and developing something. So I'll show that over here. Once that development is complete, I'll show it in here. And when this construction is complete, I'll show it in tangible assets. Getting my point? So even though it says four things, basically there are two things, tangible assets and intangible assets. Got it? I hope now if you look at the overview of the balance sheet and financial statements, you'll get to know a little bit more. Okay. And you can look at the entire thing at once and kind of figure out, okay, what did we discuss? Okay. So I would say pause the video and try to note down the each and every item that you saw. You will miss stuff. Okay. So you will miss stuff, but at least when you miss it, you know that, okay, I missed that part. Right. So that's it for the balance sheet part. And in the next video, I'm going to talk about the profit and loss account. And once these two things are done, it's more or less you have the basic to understand the balance sheet and profit and loss account of any company, right? And profit and loss is relatively much easier than the balance sheet. Okay, but I hope right now you got a little bit more clarity. And let me stop sharing. So I hope this might have helped. If you have any questions, as always, put them in the comments below. And let's meet you in the next video with the profit and loss account. Okay. So I would still suggest just stop the video and try to write down the balance sheet format on your own. You will miss things that you forgot to write down, but that's completely fine. Just write down things and always think of it in this stage format. Go back into the video and look at it again, look at it. And I hope within one or two tries, you'll get to figure out most of these things. So thank you so much for watching. Subscribe and so that get to know whenever I post new videos. And if you have any other topics that you want me to cover, please let me know in the comments below and I'll make them. Okay. Thank you so much.